Initially, the National Council on Public Transportation reported last Thursday that four routes were affected as five minibus operators were infected with COVID-19, two of them in critical condition and one deceased. By Friday, August 27th, the number of affected routes had increased to 11. Going into the weekend, 16 operators had tested positive. By Monday, the situation had worsened with 13 routes throughout the island affected and two operators still on the critical list. This, according to the council, justifies the decision to reduce the number of passengers per vehicle per trip to 10.
We had the discussion with the COVID Command Center Friday into Saturday, looking at reducing the number of persons on the public service vehicle. What we need to say to St. Lucians, the message from the National Council on Public Transportation, we are not saying that the minibus drivers are the one spreading the virus. That is not the message. Mm-hmm. The issue here is the number of persons on a public service vehicle at this time. So,
we know that the numbers currently, given the adjusted protocols, they're at yes. 10. Is that what we're speaking about? So currently, you're looking to decrease it from 10, or it was from the original 14 passengers down to 10?
From the free roper seat on Thursday into Friday because of the state of the numbers that had gone up. Mm-hmm. It was necessary to make the adjustment. However, we do understand with many route associations, the information did not get out there as quickly okay. as possible. So that is understandable. But going into today, tomorrow, and the days to follow, the maximum load per vehicle is 10 persons.
In the recent past, under the previous government, minibus operators had sought compensation from the UWP administration and had even gone on strike, stating that the reduction in passengers was preventing them from meeting their financial obligations and hurting their reputation. But Mr. Frederick says it's time to put financial issues on a side and think of safety first.
The reason for that is to forget about the financial implications, but look at the health point of view. So it is not worth trying to squeeze into a bus to get where you need to go, and then it may cost you your health or your life.
National Council on Public Transportation's vice president is also calling on the public to cooperate amid reports that some passengers insist on boarding the buses after they have reached the 10-passenger limit. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.